Let's see how it does at this U-turn here. It has gotten a lot better at the U-turns and Michigan lefts, which is something that it was struggling with maybe 6 months ago, but a lot of improvements recently. Takes them very naturally. The only question is sometimes it will put the turn signal on and try to merge over a little bit early at this first U-turn, which it's not supposed to do, and it's not so far. It thought about going and then it hit the brake. It is, however, right out in the middle of a walkway, or actually a little bit ahead of it, but it's not trying to run the yellow light, and it just a little bit of hesitation there. All right, U-turn time. Moment of truth. Pretty good. That should make an easy right turn here into the parking lot. And it typically gets pretty confused in this parking lot and just drives all the right way around Micro Center. Kind of does the scenic route here, so I'm going to take over if it does. No, this time it's actually pulling in as if it were going to park. I'm gonna take over here and try to let it do a self-park. Nicely done. All right, so I'm going to stop this recording here and set up a second one with a different gimbal or a different gimbal calibration to see if I can stop the side-to-side movement. All right, we're gonna run into Micro Center real quick. When we get back, we're just gonna do a test of the smart summon. So I'm gonna leave the camera on, keep everything rolling, and hopefully it will come and pick me up in about 5 minutes here. Stay tuned. Drive home. That's being a lot more patient about letting cars in. That's definitely a good thing. I would always hate with that on the previous revisions. Like, the only way you could get it to stop to let people out is to, you know, take it out of autopilot and hit the brakes and so it's nice that it is slowing down and letting other traffic move in at intersections. So if this was me, I would already have put the turn signal on and started to merge here, because I know this lane ends. And in about a mile, I need to be in the middle lane anyway. You gonna go?
No. Shit.
Alright, so I almost took over there. I was about to accelerate through, and then I decided to let the game of chicken run out with the big, giant truck right next to me, and the Teslas slowed down just very freaking late for it to be doing that. So, you know you need to get over in this lane. Just go ahead and get the F over. Thank you. Okay, so if this was me, I would put the turn signal on and I would go ahead and drive, which it's doing. Granted, I would have been tempted to do that 100 feet back there and did pretty good there, even though the left-hand turning car back there was pulled out well into the intersection. No problem. So this is the traffic light that it blew through the other night. You can see it's not marked on their map here, so I don't know if that's got anything to do with it. Good, it waited for the blazer there to pull out. So, knowing that I have to make a left-hand turn here, I would have already gone and put the turn signal on and started to get into the left lane. I don't understand why it waits so long to do that. Left turn there into the neighborhood street, and the question is, what is it going to do at the house? Sometimes it actually will make a left-hand turn. It's already telling me autopilot navigation is complete. Press accelerator to resume. So it puts the turn signal on as if it knows it needs to pull in here, and it starts to pull in, and then it stops, and I don't know what we're doing. We're just kind of going back and forth. You gonna do anything? Nope, you're just gonna, maybe it's waiting for me to back up, but I don't back into the house. Alright, I'm getting out of the road before traffic comes. So, all in all, pretty good. I would say that's a zero intervention drive, just a couple close calls where I was about to intervene, but the Tesla did what it was supposed to. And just a little slow to do some things. But overall, successful trip. That's full self-drive, 12.5.4. I'm trying to unload way too many 3D printer filaments and...